Okay, now that we know how to configure some basic build for QEMU, let's go back for a while to the Kconfig. So when the build is configured, the Kconfig produces two important output files containing the full set of options selected during the configuration phase. The first file is a .config file. It is created and saved within the coreboot root directory upon exiting from menu config text interface. The .config file gets included by the coreboot main make file. Its purpose is to expose the config options selected during the configuration phase to the make file so that the build system is aware what is the target configuration. Based on this information, the build system knows which source files should be built, which features should be enabled, etc. As we can see in this short example, the Boolean settings are set to yes, in short Y, or commented out with is not set string at the end. String settings can be set to any string or basically left empty. The Kconfig also allows to set various other options like various other types of options like integer or hexadecimal. Okay, so now let's see quickly how it looks like for our QEMU build, and let's use the last comment. As you can see, the header says that it is automatically generated file and it shouldn't be edited manually. So if you want to make some modifications, do it through the menu config. And you can see the headers of various sections are named by the submenus. For example, we have the general setup, and before we have the mainboard submenu, which is indicated by the mainboard header here. All right, here. And yes, we have the general setup here. And let's study the few options we see. So basically, each kconfig option, which is defined by a given name, is always appended with config underscore here. And the value selected in the menu configuration is assigned after the equal sign. So basically, this is a coreboot build Boolean value, which is set to yes. We have a string local version, which I showed you earlier, and it is configured as empty string. But here we have the CBFS prefix, which indicates how what kind of prefix should the stages have. And it's set to fallback string. You can also see other like options like config any toolchain, which allows us to use any other toolchain than coreboot one, but it is marked as not set. Let's try to find some other options like hexadecimal options or integer options. So, for example, here we have the CBFS size, which is a hexadecimal value. Or we can have an integer option. For example, the config for UART console is an integer. Here we can also max ACPA table size in kilobytes is 2224. And basically that's probably all options that are all types of options that coreboot implements in kconfig.